Hey everyone, today I'm going to try and paint a dream catcher. I can speak. My eldest daughter requested it, and I am going to use a 12 by 18 Strathmore acrylic paper. Comes in this pad. And to what I did is last night I played around with trying to draw my dream catcher. So I used the handy dandy butter lid, you know, a plastic bowl lid to make my circle. And I drew it out on paper. I don't know if you can see all my lines there. And I just kept sketching it in until I got to a shape that I like, and then traced back over it again with a fine tip black Sharpie so I could see it. Then I used a piece of tracing paper and traced over the lines that I wanted to keep so that I can transfer this image onto my canvas. Now, of course, depending on the size canvas that you use is going to depend on the size of your circle. But once I get my background painted in, I'm going to use my graphite paper and trace this onto my canvas and then go from there. So let's get started with our background. We are going to use some Phthylo Blue and a magenta to make a pink. And white. We want a light blue and a pale pink. And as the colors blend together on the canvas, we'll get a very light purplish shade too. So take a moment, get yourself set up, draw out your dream catcher on a piece of paper, get it the way you like it. If you have tracing paper, you can isolate the lines that you want to keep and then transfer it to your canvas. Or you can just go straight from your paper with your tracing paper and trace it to your canvas. Or if you feel really comfortable with your drawing skills, just draw it on your canvas with some chalk erasers. So I'm going to get my paint colors all set up and I will be back. Okay, so I have my palette set up for my background, and today I am going to try my new paintbrush. It is a Simply Simmons number 10, a bright, but it is for oil paints. And I'm using acrylics, but it's nice and stiff. So I'm gonna see how this works. We're going to just mix a little blue with some white to get a nice light color blue. You know, we don't want it super dark because we want our our dream catcher to stand out. And we'll do the same thing with whatever you choose for your magenta color or red to make your pink with. I am going to use Alizarin Crimson, and I can tell you already I like this brush. It is pushing the paint around my canvas very nicely. So I'm adding more white to my brush without mixing it in with the blue, and I am not minding what direction that my brush stroke is in because I just want to fill in my canvas. And this is going to be the background, and I don't want any of my white canvas showing through. So I'm just flopping it around on there. And In case you don't know, Phthalo Blue is a very strong, strong color. And it's got hair. It's a really strong color, so it does not take much to, another hair up there. Oh, okay, so my brush is shedding. Anyways, it does not take much to put some color on the canvas with some Phthalo. Okay, so I think now I'm going to add pink into the picture. And I did not rinse my brush. Just dabbed into it. White, lighten that up, blend it across into the blue. Excuse how the board is shaking. It's I bought this cheap easel off of Amazon for $10, and it's not exactly the best. To be honest, I usually paint flat on the table, but I was trying to figure out a way of doing these videos so that you can see. And I do quite honestly prefer painting flat on the table, but for perspective reasons, you really need it to be on an easel, because if you're trying to make something look like it has dimension, it needs to be the way you see it. You know, your canvas needs to be up if you're painting something that is up, so that your perspective is not off. Some more water on my brush. Come back into some more blue. Okay, so I like how the brush is moving the paint on the canvas, but I'm not necessarily too happy with it leaving the hairs everywhere. But that could just be the newness to it. I don't know, this is my first time using this brush. And it does hold the water nicely. That's a little sore today. So once you have your whole background painted in, to your satisfaction, then you're going to let it dry so that you can trace your image onto the canvas. So you can wait in real time and let it dry, take a break, rest your shoulders, because I'm finding this quite tough on my shoulders at the moment. And just give yourself a break, or you can break out the old hair dryer and dry it quickly so you can keep working. Blue down here. I'm liking the flow of this. I am. So I've drawn my dream catcher out on paper. I spent the last couple of days practicing different techniques of how to paint feathers and bubbles. I haven't quite decided yet if I want to put some bubbles floating up through. And Yeah, just May. Let's see how it goes with the feathers and the dream catcher. So I didn't realize that dream catchers were still so popular. They were, long time ago. Gosh, I want to say late 80s, early 90s. They were pretty popular. But I haven't heard too much about them, so I was quite surprised when my daughter asked for one. And she's, very crafty and very up on the current trends of the time. So I guess that means that they are back in. Now, I will apologize in advance if I get interruptions doing this video, because my other half, just for some reason, when I'm trying to tape, he cannot stay out of my room. He can't stay out of this craft room. He's got to come in and be a nosy rosy and talk. And sometimes he forgets that, not everybody quite talks the same way that he does. So I see him pulling up outside, and I'll apologize now if he comes in and he does that. I will try to stop the camera before he can interrupt. But we shall see what happens. And I am almost done. I'm at the very bottom. And I did notice a few spots up in here that I might need to revisit. A little bit more paint. Just to make sure that canvas is not peeking through. That bugs me more than anything. And they say that it is not you, the painter, that it is your tools, either the type of canvas that you're using, or the type of paint, or even the brush that you are using. So, and I'm finding a lot that it, I think, in my opinion, is definitely the brush. And it could be the grade of paint, but I think more so the brush than anything. Okay. So I think that I am liking that, and we are going to let it dry. I will be back. Okay, so I have attached my tracing paper with artist tape, and underneath that is my graphite paper. Now I had to pull my easel down, or my canvas down, and put it flat to trace it, and I'm pretty sure that it's pretty self-explanatory. You draw over the lines with your pen to transfer your image. So I have already done that. I'm going to remove that. And all I have on here is just my dream catcher itself. I did not trace my strings or feathers or anything like that. So, some people say that this won't work on acrylic paints. I think it works just fine, especially if the background is light. I didn't press very hard. I used my ballpoint pen to trace over. And, you can see some of my lines aren't perfect, so I may have to go back and fix where I did that. So, try to be careful when you're in your tracing process, that you don't have a lot of lines, especially when you're tracing something that's not going to be a solid image. And now for the fun part of painting it in. So you have to decide, what colors do you want to use? Do you want black, since black stands out? Or do you want to use like burnt umber, that's a very dark brown? Sorry, I had to go grab my drink. I think that I'm going to try the burnt umber. And if I don't like it, you know what? I can paint over it. Get the cap off of this tube. There we go. So yeah, I'm going to try burnt umber for the round part and possibly the strings. And we'll start off with my angle brush. I don't know that that's the brush I'm going to use. You use whatever brush you feel comfortable with using. Whatever you feel like you have more control over, be it an angle, a flat, a detailed round, whichever. So I'm going to try and do this. Like I said, I like to paint flat, so this is going to be maybe a little bit hard for me. So I'm going to do my outer circle first. And my little angle brush that I'm using is very small. It does not hold a lot of paint, so I may have to go back and do more than one coat of paint. Especially, see how it's giving me streaks in it? It just doesn't hold a lot of paint. It's very small. But I feel like I have more control when it's small. Necessarily need to see me paint in the whole thing. I wouldn't think so. It's, you know, just doing the whole circle. And in my case, like I said, I'll have to do two coats. So odds of me messing up are even greater because I have to do this twice. I hear somebody sneaking in here. Is that you, Jenna? Or is it a cat? Actually, it's neither. That crackling noise I heard is John starting a big old fire in the fire pit. You know how men are. They are definitely some pyros. And because the weather is a little bit nicer today, I get to have some windows open, which is so nice to let some fresh air in from the staleness of being cooped up for the winter time. Oh yeah, definitely two coats on this. Black because black is very stark and just stands right out there. And I thought, you know, originally when dream catchers were made, they made them from things in nature. And you know what? There is no black in nature. There's very darks, but there are no true blacks in nature. I'm sorry if I get quiet here, I'm just trying to concentrate. So I don't have very many errors to fix. I don't know if it's just me, but I feel like when I have to fix an error, I can still see it. And I know it's because I know it's there, but the less I have to correct, the better. So when you draw out your dream catcher, you can decide where you want the center to be. It doesn't have to be dead in the middle. It can be off to the side, it can be up closer to the top, down near the bottom, and then all your strings tend to gravitate towards that. So, you know, that's just completely your choice. And I know some people on YouTube here, they'll give you traceables to use. I mean, I could do that if somebody really wanted it, but it's just too easy to sit there and sketch it out on a piece of paper and make your adjustments, and then use, you know, darken your lines that you want to keep, and use a piece of tracing paper, which you can get at, you know, stores like Dollar Tree, and trace out the lines that you're keeping, and then transfer it to the paper. I mean, I got my transfer paper on Amazon. I want to say it was like less than $5. I'm trying to be very thin and straight here. It was like less than $5 for the package. It came with three sheets, and it had free shipping because of Prime. But I'm sure you can pick it up at any of your local craft stores. Now I'm using burnt umber here with a little bit of white mixed in to lighten the color, and I'm just trying to follow my lines carefully as I can with light pressure. The lighter the pressure, the thinner your line. Now if I happen to get fat with it, put a bead where it sticks. Where I got fat with it. Now this is definitely one thing that these little angle brushes are good for, is making these nice little lines. And I am having to rest my hand. And sometimes, if you're finding that you're not getting that straight line, put your hand down and let the, you know, rest it on this part of your hand. Let the movement be only your hand, not your shoulder, not your elbow, because it can make a really big difference on being able to apply the pressure and control. I am probably going to have to turn this canvas here in a minute so that I can do these lines, because I just want them as straight and as thin as I can possibly get them. And I need to be able to see and control my wrist. Because, you know, I, of course, had to, whoops, got a little fat there. I had to pick a long, skinny canvas. But I want my feathers to have room to hang down. And I wanted it big enough to where it can be seen. So I did pick a kind of long skin canvas. But you know what? As far as the straightness goes, I'm not going to sweat it, because if I wanted it perfect, I'd find a dream catcher and just take a picture. It wouldn't look painted. It wouldn't look, oops, that definitely got fat. It wouldn't look hand-drawn. Yeah, we'll be correcting that. And I gotta turn the canvas. That's because I need to turn the canvas. So if you will pardon me for a minute, I don't know what you're gonna see here. Probably just the background. Not much of me doing any work. But you know what? Tell you what. You already see the process here. I'm going to pause the video and get this painted in so that you're not looking at a blank canvas. Okay. While we were off camera, I fixed some of my lines. I did the second coat on my ring, and I painted in the ring in the center with the burnt umber. So the next thing would be to decide where your string's going to come down and where your feather's going to be. And I am going to hopefully be able to do this with it on the easel like that. Use this light color, the burnt umber mixed with the white, so that light, you know, because that's my string color there. Feathers are going to be fun too at this angle. Oh, I didn't practice them that way. Okay, so I'm going to use a liner brush. Do that. And you got to mix your paint kind of like, not watery, but inky. Thin, but not so watered down that you can't do anything with it. So, in pictures that I looked at, you have strings coming from the bottom, and there's usually strings coming from the sides. So, I think that I'm going to start here and bring the string out. And with it, I'm going to bring another string. One more. They say that odd numbers are better. Now I could do my strings longer, but I'm just trying to get them in there. And from here, longer, but considering the length of my canvas, I think those are going to be good because I want room for my feathers too. So, rinse that brush out so we don't ruin it. And feathers. Oh my goodness, I'm scared to death. All right, I'm going to get a slightly bigger angle brush. Now's when we get to add some color. So most of the tube colors are really, really bright. So I'm going to get some yellow, some cad yellow, and not a lot. I end up wasting so much paint. I think I'm putting a tiny bit on my palette, and I always have this huge amount left over. Really, really annoying to throw that paint away. So I'm just putting little tiny squeezes. And you know, this stuff isn't cheap, especially if you get the artist quality. And maybe a little dioxazine purple to make a light purple color with the white. And I haven't even used it yet. My fingers are covered with it. And a green. I think some sap green. And we already have blue on our palette from the Phthylo Blue, so we have that. So I'm going to dampen my brush. Keep my fingers crossed that my feathers work out. I want to lighten my yellow. Well, add some white because yellow is such a translucent color. It doesn't really show. So I'm gonna put some yellow and white on my brush. Start and make my line for the center of my feather. And then I'm going to flick, 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 flick. You gotta have that little flick on the end to feather it out. Oops, too far, not far enough. And of course, as it gets down towards the tip, you know, the strokes aren't quite as big. I'm going to come over to the other side and go flick, 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 flick. Put some more paint on my brush. Orange. looking good. Okay, so got my brush. Let's do a little bit green. Now, if you want it to be a bright green, you're going to put your green with some white, pastel it down, and if you want to brighten it up, you do that with the yellow. And not all feathers are the same size. Not all feathers are perfectly even either. They have chunks possibly missing out of them. If you've ever looked at a feather under a magnifying glass, they have these little things on them that like help lock them together, kind of like a Ziploc bag, and trying to concentrate, sorry. It's, you can sit there and like run your fingers the wrong way on the feather, and you get these big gaping chunks, you know, where they're not put together, and smoothing them back in the proper direction makes them lock up. It's, I guess what I was trying to get at is, you know, they're not all perfect, so don't sweat the small stuff, and this is a painting, not a picture, so it's not going to be perfect, and you shouldn't want it to be perfect. So I think that we need over here to have a pretty feather, and I'm going to run him off the page. Are you being able to see what I'm doing? Let's try to zoom in. And that didn't help any, did it? It needs to be leaned. This. Oops, nausea again. Okay. No, let me try this. Click. Hold this so you can see. Okay. Then the other side. Flick, 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 flick. And that feather's off the page. Okay. Try to put this back to where it was. That's a little better. It's lowered down. many and as few feathers as you want. Just try to keep it at an odd number. For some reason, it just looks more pleasing to the eye. Touch back into that with just red that's not kneaded down by the white. Wait till it dries and see what it looks like. The colors dry a little bit different. And my hands are covered with paint. I just picked that up the wrong way. Let's see, what color do we want to use next? How about a blue? Should we throw a blue in there? Just wiping some of this paint off my hands. Let's do some blue. I'm gonna have some more white paint. Okay. Woo, I got that there. This feather, I think that we will have to come back into some white. Give it some highlights. That is a happy feather. There. Yeah, I like that feather better. Okay. I'm not even gonna rinse my brush. I'm gonna mix that in with my yellow and white. And Phthylo Blue and Cad Yellow kind of gives you a turquoise color. Now, I'm going to have a little turquoise on here. Start with a comma off the page. And the other side, still like a comma. My brush out because I don't want that turquoise again. Not right now, anyways. So, they want yellow again. Yellow, white. Definitely when you're painting this, make sure your canvas is at an angle that you are comfortable with. But I think we're looking pretty darn good. Wow, I hate to say it, but I think I need another red here. I am not even going to mix my red with the white this time. Too much water on my brush. Okay. And I think I want my feather to curve that way.
Thank you.
feathers are in. And I'm gonna let that dry because I'm noticing I'm sticking my pinky into my feathers and I'm making little marks. So we're gonna let it dry and come back. Okay, so I've given that a little bit of time to dry. Excuse me. Now you want to make the veins down the centers of the feathers, and you're going to use your darker color to do that. That's in the feather. Like this one is yellow, so I'm going to draw the line in yellow, which this actually has a little bit of orange on it. I'm wondering if I should. I think I will. I need to get my little bitty angle brush into my line. Pressure gets you the thin line and be at the angle that you are comfortable with. Not like me. Okay, so shake. Sorry, I don't mean to whisper. Feeling my hand can be steady enough floating in the air. So I'm going to take a pencil and I'm going to use the eraser. And I'm just going to dip that in some paint. And I'm going to dab on a bead. Here and there and everywhere, up in here, where your strings cross over. Now, change up your colors. There, I want to have it in some other places, so I'm trying to, while it is still wet, get some in here before it completely dries up on me. Here. this changing of colors. Never use the purple. See what I mean? Wasting paint. What is up with that? I think that where all of these need to eat on them too. Let's just play with some of that purple. I want some purple. Got yellow mixed in with that. Yeah, that's not good. Yellow and purple make gray. We do not want gray. No more purple than that. Okay. I think this guy needs another bead. There we go. That way, it's not a total waste, right? We need to be right in the center. Right up there in the center, and I think it needs to be the purple. So, a little bit darker than that. Maybe we want some beads at the top of our swing. Maybe we don't. That is up to you. I think we have enough beads on there. So, and you can give your beads a little bit of a dimension. So on my red beads, I'm going to mix a little bit of purple
in with my red to make it a darker shade, darker tone red. And I'm just going to like a little comma on the outer one side of it. So, beads are cool, right? Then you gotta go back and do all this to them. The more beads you have, the more that you're doing. Okay, so, our blue, what do we do with our blue? Gotta give it a shadow, so take a little bit of your purple and mix it in with your little blue. Give it a darker color, and then you could probably use that on the purple too. So purple and blue beads. Enough to have your canvas while you are comfortable painting. Sure. Okay, so you got a shadow side, but now you need a highlight side, right? Where there's a shadow, there must be a highlight. Maybe. So, I'm going to put the light on all of them. And of course, on some, you know, color will show better than on others. I'm really trying not to stick my hand in any wet paint. That just gave our beads a whole lot of dimension. Pretty cool, huh? All right, so now where our strings are attached, are they just hanging there? Probably not. So we're gonna go back into that nice tan light brown color that we made with our white and our umber. And I'm gonna try and do this with our liner brush and not make a mess. But it should be like wrapped around the little thingy here. Because they're not just floating out in the middle of nowhere. Are attached, maybe they should have a little wrap, at least one, right? You know what else I think? I think that we need a highlight on there.
Do I feel confident in doing that?
Yes and no.
But we're gonna try. So our beads have the highlight on this side, so we kind of need to come to the side, give a little shine. On the same token that it's on that side, it's going to be on the inside of this side. So, let's see about. And, you know, broken line, doesn't have to be a solid line. Guess what? Where there's a highlight, there should be a shadow. Where's my, there it is. So I need to darken my brown. And I'm gonna darken my brown by using some of my Phthylo Blue. And that's gonna make it just a little bit darker. At least this way I get to use up some of this paint that I put on my palette. That was too much, right? Okay. One of these days, I will figure it out. So, since I have highlight here, on this side, I'm going to have some shadow. I lowered the camera. I don't know if you saw any of that I just did. Well, part of it. Part of it. Okay, let me raise you up. Hang on. Oops. Okay. So I added the highlight on the inside here, on the outside of this side, the shadow on the inside of this side, and on the outside there. Sorry, one of these days I'm gonna get good at this videotaping thing. So what I'm doing is I'm trying to give it a little bit of dimension so that it doesn't look like it's just on a flat surface. So, in here, I think in the middle, we should have some highlight. Back to my white. Coming this way. Here.
And there's highlight. There's shadow. So just giving it a little touch. I kind of want to add more beads, but I don't. Okay, so now is our dream catcher just there, or is it hanging? So I think it needs a string that runs off the canvas so that it's not just floating in space. So we're going to like that. And it has to wrap around our thing because it can't just be floating there. Okay. Now, there's only one thing left to do. Sign it. Signature time. I cannot write with a paintbrush, so I'm going to sign it with one of these. It is a, what do you call it? Like a jelly pen? Gel pen? I'm just going to put my hand on the bottom. And that, my friends, come out. That is okay, so there's not enough room in here for me to back up far enough with this camera to give you a full view of the picture. So, but this is our dream catcher. There's our feathers and the circle, and it's hanging. I think we did a fabulous job, and I hope you paint this with me. And have fun. I mean, there's just any way you can do that design. This, get a close up for you. If you can see how the highlights made the and the shadows gave that dimension. Looks really cool, especially through the camera. And our beads. See the beads? Highlight on one side, shadow on the other. Feathers. That one, at least on this camera, looks really dark. That is really a bright reddish orange. They're all very bright colors, but this camera, through its lens, tends to give it a dark hue to it, but it really isn't. Anyhow, thank you so much. Enjoy painting this and designing your dream catcher. So I'll see you next time at your canvas.